Welcome back. So last time we were here, we managed to defeat Asgore and end up, well, it says we got to the end, but then we got some feedback to the effect that, there might still be more some more game to be played. So with that in mind, let's continue where we left off, because the end is not really the end. So, during the game, we did neglect a couple of side quests. One of those quests was to go. Well, you remember, right? You remember our buddy Papyrus and how he tried to capture us? And I forget if he succeeded. I don't think he did. But he mentioned how after he captured us, we were going to go on a date. And I guess either through not getting captured or just through willful ignorance on my part, we missed that date. So we gotta go make up that date. We gotta have our date with Papyrus. Also, there are a couple other characters that we met up with along the way that. Well, we'll see. It'd be wrong to spoil everything. Oops, that's the wrong way. Is this the right way? No, that's wrong also. Is this the way out? Oh, this'll work. Oops. Oh, yeah, you guys remember this guy? You remember his name? Yeah, I remembered his name. And I'm not telling you guys what it was. Seeing such a strange laboratory. All right, off stage. In a place like this, you're filled with determination. That's the lab. But here we are. Tra-la-la. I'm the Riverman. Or am I the River Woman? Doesn't really matter. I'd love to ride my boat. Would you care to join me? Sure, why not? Let's go to our date. Well, yeah, it would be Stockholm Syndrome if he did successfully capture me. Tra-la-la. I should have worn a few more pairs of pants today. Come again sometime. Tra-la-la. Man. That's quite the job right there. That would make a fantastic loading screen. That and the fact that you actually see the splash and you hear the noise. Like that. You could just leave that going. That'd be a fantastic loading screen. We've already visited, I was meaning to stand next to the door here. You see how it says Librarbri. We've already been to the library, and pointed out their spelling error. Oh man, you see I'm walking left, I'm walking right, and he's following me. He's really looking forward to this date. What if I try going to his house without him? Wow, you're so. What voice did I give him? Does anybody remember the voice I gave him, guy? Oh yeah. The Great Papyrus. There we go. Whoa! You're so eager to date me? You're trying to go into my house without me. That's really weird. Well, you're really weird. So you came back to have a date with me. You must be really serious about this. I have to take you someplace really special. A place I like to spend a lot of time. Ooh, is it the library? No. Is it... No, it's not Grillby's. Not the library. My house. Okay. Welcome to Scenic My House. Enjoy and take your time. It's a joke book. Should we look into the joke book, guys? Inside the joke book was a quantum physics book. You look inside. Inside that was another joke book. You look inside that joke book. There's another quantum physics book. It's a joke. It's so meta. You decide to stop. Ooh, it's my favorite game show. It says, stay tuned for a new program. MTT. What? It's usually better than this. It's just a bad episode. Don't judge me. It's a dirty sock with a series of post-it notes. I know it's post-it notes. Well, I guess it's not post-it notes. It's just sticky notes. Sans, please pick up your sock.
Okay.
Don't put it back down. Move it.
Okay.
You moved it 2 inches. Move it to your room.
Okay.
Don't bring it back.
Okay.
It's still here.
Didn't you just say not to bring it back to my room?
Ah, forget it. You touch the couch. It makes a jangling sound. Find a bunch of loose coins. 20G. The door is locked. A classic image. It always reminds me of what's important in life. Just let that settle in. This is my brother's pet rock. He always forgets to feed it. As usual, I have to take responsibility. Oh, rocks covered in sprinkles. Well, I mean, things could be different down here in the underworld. Or the underground. Sorry. So maybe the rock does actually eat the sprinkles. I mean, that could be a thing down here. Wait. You mean, there's this little spot, this little corner, and I can't do anything there. I do appreciate, though, like, if I go left and right, Papyrus is, like, paying attention. He's super attentive. And that's just... I'm impressed that they went to that level of detail with the game. Aha! Interested in my food museum? Please, peruse my culinary art show. And it's all spaghetti. The other half... It's just an empty bag of chips. Great. That's the trash can. Feel free to visit it any time. Okay. Impressed? I increased the height of my sink. Now I can fit more bones under it. Take a look-see. Hey, it's that dog from when we had our battle with Papyrus. What? Catch that meddling canine. Gusses. Sans, stop plaguing my life with incidental music. get it. My brother always goes out to eat, but recently he tried baking something. It was like a quiche, but filled with a sugary, non-egg substance. How absurd. Empty pie tin. I wonder what it is that Sans could have been cooking. Come on, can I demonstrate this Easter egg properly? This is actually harder to demonstrate than I thought. Man, let's do this. Maybe I need to do this on keyboard. This is actually harder. It seems that way anyhow. Dang, I can't do this. Well, I'll just have to leave it to you guys to do the research and figure out what happens when you exploit this. Because I appear not to have the skill to pull it off. It's actually not so easy. Trying to play Pong with Papyrus and it's just not working. That's a really tight window. Like, there's the Sans battle and then there's this. I'm sorry I'm failing so poorly. Okay, I found the threshold. It's the tile here and the threshold itself. So let's wait until he's halfway there. No. I thought it was the tile and the threshold. Apparently not. I'm so distracted trying to monitor both sides. I can't time that just right. Whatever. Yeah, I almost had it. I guess we'll keep trying. Just bear with me. We'll get it, guys. I can just, like, type accurately. How am I gonna do this? It's almost easier with one finger than with two. There we go. Easter egg unlocked. I can't feel my legs. That must mean I'm being a great host. All right. Is he not gonna join us in the kitchen? Fine. That's all we get. Easter egg unlocked. That should be like a Steam achievement right there. Just saying. That's my room. If you've finished looking around, we could go in and do whatever people do when they date. Well, let's progress the story. It's totally worth it. Hey, those are all the attacks I used on you. Great memories, huh? Seems it was only yesterday, even though it basically just happened. Technically, it's been a number of days, but I'll let it slide. The internet. I'm quite popular there. I'm just a dozen away from a double-digit follower count. A dozen away from... So that means he's like at negative 3 or something? Of course, fame has a steep price. A jealous troll has besieged my online persona, always sending me bad puns in a goofy font. I bet Sans is the troll. There are no skeletons inside my closet except me sometimes. Clothes are hung up neatly inside. Okay. What does he read? That book's one of my favorites. Advanced Puzzle Construction for Critical Minds. That next book's another one of my favorites. Peekaboo with Fluffy Bunny. Does anybody actually have a copy of this book, Peekaboo with Fluffy Bunny? I think just the contrast between those two is fantastic. The ending always gets me. Isn't that flag Nito? Undyne found it at the Pirate Bay. I think it's from the human world? Now, I know what you're thinking. Why would a human flag have a cool skeleton on it? Well, I have a theory. I think humans must have descended from skeletons. Yeah! You're not wrong. Maybe. Ah, yes. Action figures. A great reference for theoretical battle scenarios. How do I have so many? Well, let's just say they're from a chubby, smiling man who loves to surprise people. Yeah, that's right. Santa! Oh, I should have turned off Steam Overlay. My bad. That's my bed. If I ever get to the surface, I'd like to drive down a long highway. Wind in my hair, sun on my skin. Of course, that's just a dream. So instead, I cruise while I snooze. Well, let's go. That was fun. Let's go back and back up and back up and down. Yeah. So, if you've seen everything, do you want to start the date? Okay. Dating start. Here we are on our date. I've actually never done this before, but don't worry. You can't spell prepared without several letters from my name. I snagged an official dating rulebook from the library. We're ready to have a great time. Let's see. Step 1. Press the C key on your keyboard for dating HUD. Wowie! I feel so informed! I think we're ready for step 2. Ask them on a date. Human, I, the great Papyrus, will go on a date with you.
Nope.
Fortunately, it only says to ask. I guess that means it's time for part 3. Step 3, put on nice clothes to show you care. Wait a second. Wear clothing. That apron you put on. You're wearing clothing right now. Not only that, earlier today you were also wearing clothing. No, could it be? You've wanted to date me from the very beginning.
Nope.
Despite that, you chose to wear clothing today, of all days? Was your interest in me predestined? No, your dating power. Yeah. Don't think you've bested me yet. I, the great Papyrus, have never been beaten at dating, and I never will. Can easily keep up with all you.
You see, I too can wear clothing. In fact, I always wear my special clothes underneath my regular clothes, just in case somebody happens to ask me anything. Behold. Yeah, what do you think of my secret style?
Be honest, it's actually pretty cool.
No, a genuine compliment. However, you don't truly understand the hidden power of this outfit. Therefore, what you just said is invalid. This date won't escalate any further unless you find my secret. But that won't happen.
Let's see, can I go in the corner and... Oh. Apparently there's nothing to inspect other than papyrus here. So...
Human souls are stronger than monster souls, but the soles of our shoes, on the other hand, are about the same. Hold in my hand so I'll tell you the answer. No, I must resist. There is no secret to my legs, just hard work and perseverance. I see, you like caressing my biceps with a floating heart. But who doesn't? The shirt didn't originally say cool, but I improved it. All clothing articles can be improved this way.
Oops.
My hat?
I was clicking your face, but sure.
My hat. Well then, you found my secret. Suppose I have no choice. It's a present. Just for you.
Nope.
You can't even bring yourself to harm my delicate wrapping. That technique. It's too strong. Counterattack. I'll open the present myself.
Do you know what this is?
Yeah, that's right. You have no idea. Though this appears to be spaghetti... Ain't any plain old pasta. It's an artisan's work. Silken spaghetti, finely aged in an oaken cask. And cooked by me, Master Chef Pyrus. Human, it's time to end this. There's no way this can go any further. You take a small bite. Your face reflexively scrunches up. It's indescribable. What a passionate expression. You must really love my cooking. And by extension, me. Maybe even more than I do. Ah! No! Poor Papyrus. Human, it's clear now. You're madly in love with me. Everything you do, everything you say, it's all been for my sake. Human, I want you to be happy too. It's time for me to express my feelings. It's time I told you, Papyrus, is it hot in here, or is it just me? Oh, shoot, human, I'm sorry, I don't like you the way you like me, romantically, I mean, I tried very hard to, I thought because you flirted with me that I was supposed to go on a date with you. Then, on the date, feelings would blossom forth. I'd be able to match your passion for me, but alas, I, the great Papyrus, have failed. I feel just the same as before. And instead, by dating you, I've only drawn you deeper into your intense love for me. A dark prison of passion with no escape. How could I have done this to my dear friend? No, wait, that's wrong. I can't fail. Human, I'll help you through these trying times. I'll keep being your cool friend and act like this all never happened. After all, you are very great. It'd be tragic to lose your friendship. So please, don't cry because I won't kiss you. Because I don't even have lips. And hey, someday we'll find someone as great as me. Well, no, that's not true, but I'll help you find... Help you settle for second best. Yeah. And if you ever need to reach me, here's my phone number. You can call me anytime. Platonically. Well, gotta go. Computer's internet is still open to a social media site. Well, wonder where Papyrus went. Should we call him? You're in my house. Good choice. Though, I guess it's technically Sansa's house, too. But I prefer not to discuss his part of it. His room is... it's like another world. A world where they don't know how to vacuum.
Okay, so, to answer your question, you're asking how do you get colored sprites? You search the internet, download the colored sprites mod, and apply it to your game. Basically, you're compiling the game from scratch. So, tra-la-la, care for a ride? Sure. Let's go to Waterfall. Temi Village, the room before the Darkening Lantern room. Also, you see that this isn't a boat we're on. This is... I don't even know what this is. It's like if a chocobo were crossed with a cat, were crossed with a boat, were crossed with maybe a few other things. You end up with this. Well, it's good of him to cue me as to where a Temi village is, though. That's not how cats work. Come again sometime. Let's see. I'm kind of lost here. Did I go the wrong way? I wager I did. I was probably supposed to take the top path. Get some pasta. Doesn't sound bad. Oh wait, now this is the wrong way, isn't it? Ah, never mind. Yeah, I did something last time around that kind of ticked this dude off. Let's see. By this point, I'm already gone. The fastest way back would actually be to keep continuing this direction, and then take another intermission here. So, yeah, I completely missed the snail farm and all the other places back there. Tra-la-la, care for a ride? Yeah, let's ride again. Take me back to Waterfall. Alright, he's probably going to say something we've already seen him say before. I'll try not to accomplish anything meaningful while Cat the Narcorn is away getting pasta. Alright. Tra-la-la. Oh, suddenly feeling tropical. Okay. So, what? Is there anything up here? That's not what I was aiming for. How about over here? There we go. I've got to learn my geography sometime. Oh, the human arrives. Are you ready to hang out with Undyne? I have a plan to make you two great friends.
Nope.
Still getting ready. Take your time. What? It's a living. Okay. All readied up to hang out? Take your time. Okay, we'll say we're ready. Okay, stand behind me. Psst. Make sure to give her this. She loves these. Oh. Wait, I don't think I gave Undyne a voice, or if I did, it was a pretty awful voice, so we're gonna have to come up with a different one. At the risk of embarrassing myself, I'll try something. Okay, we'll do something that no other streamer's done, I guess, for Undyne's voice.
Hi, Papyrus. Ready for your extra private one-on-one training?
You bet I am. And I brought a friend.
Hi, I don't think we've... Why don't you two come in?
I'll just leave him. You hear someone shouting, a whisper. Shouting a whisper at you from inside the house. You can't escape friendship. Okay. I guess we can't escape friendship, guys. Here, Undyne. My friend brought a gift for you. On their own.
Thanks. I'll put it with the others. So, are we ready to start?
Oopsie doopsie, I just remembered. I have to go to the bathroom. You two have fun!
So, why are you here? To rub a victory in my face? Humiliate me even further, is that it?
Nope.
Why are you here? Wait, I get it. You think I'm gonna be friends with you, huh? Right? What? First you parade into my house, then you insult me. You little brat. I have half a mind to... Wait. I'll prove you wrong. We are going to be friends. In fact, we are going to be besties. I'll make you like me so much, your whole life will revolve around me. It's the perfect revenge. Now, why don't you have a seat?
Man, that hurts. I'll try not to do that too much.
I can't believe he leapt through the window like that. Normally he nails the landing. One time, Alfie's, friend came over here. All he did was lie seductively on the piano and fed himself grapes. I don't really like that guy, but I admire his lifestyle. You want to see my room? Too bad. No nerds allowed. Well, maybe some nerds.
Teacup in the shape of a fish. That's... Oh, I get it. Because... Yeah.
Serving some top-of-the-line MTT thing. But, you know, as much as technology advances, nothing beats home food home-cooked with fire magic.
Silverware drawer? Forks, spoons, knives... Tiny swords, axes, spears, nunchucks. Somebody likes their anime, that's for sure.
I hate cold food. So, Alfie's fixed up my fridge so it heats up food instead. A hot fridge, the world's greatest invention.
Actually, pretty nice idea.
Humans suck, but their history kind of rules. Case in point, this giant sword. Historically, humans wielded swords up to 10 times their size. Right?
Actually, no.
You liar. I've read Alfie's history book and collection. I know all about your giant swords, your colossal alien-fighting robot, your supernatural princesses. There's no way you're gonna fool me.
Alright, let's progress.
Comfortable? I'll get you something to drink. All set. What would you like?
Well, let's see. Let's pick...
Hey, don't get up. You're the guest. Sit down and enjoy yourself. I'll just point to what you want. You can use the spear.
Well,
are you hitting on me? That sugar's for the tea. I'm not gonna give you a cup of sugar. What do I look like, the ice cream woman? Do ice cream women terrorize humanity with energy spears? Are their ice cream songs a prelude to destruction? Is that it?
Nope.
That's what I thought.
What if he says yes? Game doesn't even let you pick that. That's interesting.
Oh, soda. Actually, even though you pointed to it, you don't look happy. That's fine. I think soda's gross, too. It rots your teeth. It rots your mind. It rots your fighting spirit. Why do I have it? What? You want to throw the spear at it? Oh, you want some hot chocolate? Wait. I just remembered that container's empty.
Damn it! I wanted hot chocolate. Hot chocolate's always nice. Summer, spring, winter, or fall.
I stopped getting it because always a hassle. Asgore kept getting marshmallows stuck in his beard. Container's empty.
Yeah, but I want my hot chocolate, so you're gonna give me my hot chocolate. Or not. Sword acquired taste.
Believe me, I would gladly give you your fill of swords if you weren't my beloved house guest. Fridge. You want to have the entire fridge? No.
Okay. Tea box. Blatantly correct choice.
Tea, huh? Coming right up. It'll take a moment for the water to boil. Okay, it's all done. Here we are. Careful, it's hot. It's not that hot, just drink it.
You take a sip. It scorches and melts your entire face off. But other than that, it's pretty good.
Pretty good, right? Nothing but the best for my absolutely precious friend. Hey, you know, it's kind of strange you chose that tea. Golden flower tea, that's Asgore's favorite kind. Actually, now that I think about it, you kind of remind me of him. You're both total weenies. Sort of. You know, I was a pretty hot-headed kid. Once, to prove I was the strongest, I tried to fight Asgore. Emphasis on tried. Couldn't land a single blow on him. And worse, the whole time, he refused to fight back. I was so humiliated. Afterwards, he apologized and said something goofy. Excuse me, do you want to know the best way? Do you want to know how to beat me? I said yes. From then on, he trained me. One day, during practice, I finally knocked him down. I felt bad, but he was beaming. I had never seen someone more proud to get their butt kicked. Anyway, long story short, he kept training me, and now I'm the head of the Royal Guard, so I'm the one who gets to train dorks to fight. Like, Papyrus. But, to be honest, I don't know if I can ever let Papyrus into the Royal Guard. Don't tell him I said that. He's just, well, I mean, it's not that he's weak. He's actually pretty freaking tough. It's just, he's too innocent and nice. I mean, look, he was supposed to capture you, and he ended up being friends with you instead. You can never send him into battle. You get ripped into little smiling shreds. That's part of why I started teaching him how to cook, you know. So, maybe he can do something else with his life. Oh, sorry, I was talking for so long. You're out of tea, aren't you? I'll get you some more. Wait a second. Papyrus's cooking lesson. You were supposed to have that right now. And if he's not here to have it, you'll have to have it for him. That's right. Nothing has brought Papyrus and I closer than cooking. Which means, if I give you his lesson, we'll become closer than you can ever imagine. We're gonna be best friends. Let's start with the sauce. Envision these vegetables as your greatest enemy. Now, pound them to dust with your fists.
You pet the vegetables in an affectionate manner.
Oh my god, stop petting the enemy. I'll show you how it's done. Yeah. Okay. We'll just scrape this into a bowl later. But now, we add the noodles. Homemade noodles are the best. But I just buy store brand. They're the cheapest. Ah! Just put them in the pot.
You place the noodles in, one at a time. They clank against the empty bottom.
Nice. All right, it's time to stir the pasta. The more you stir, the better it is. Ready? Stir harder. Harder. Let me do it.
This is not a blind playthrough.
It's the stuff. Alright, now for the final step. Turn up the heat. Let the stovetop symbolize your passion and your hopes and dreams turn into burning fire. Ready? Don't hold back.
Oh, I can see the dial turning. That's kind of cool.
Hotter! Hotter, darn it! Hotter! Wait, that's...
GG.
Man, no wonder Papyrus sucks at cooking. So, what's next? Scrapbooking? Friendship bracelets? Oh, who am I kidding? I really screwed this up, didn't I? I can't force you to like me, human. Some people just don't get along with each other. I understand if you feel that way about me. And if we can't be friends, that's okay. Because if we're not friends, It means I can destroy you without regret. I've been defeated. My house in shambles. I even failed to befriend you. That's it. I don't care if you're my guest. One final rematch, all out on both sides. It's the only way I can regain my lost pride.
He's letting me make the first attack. Wait, what's this? You equipped the locket. Attack 41, defense? Huh. Why is it shaking? I wonder. Don't hold back. Yeah.
What? That's the best you can manage. Even attacking at full force. You just can't muster any intent to hurt me, huh? You know what? I don't actually want to hurt you either. At first, I hated your stupid saccharine shtick, but the way you hit me right now, it reminded me of someone I used to train with. Now I know you aren't just some wimpy loser. You're a wimpy loser with a big heart. Just like him. Listen, human. It seems you and Asgore are fated to fight. But knowing him, he probably doesn't want to. Talk to him. Pretty sure you could persuade him to let you go home. Eventually, some mean human will fall down here, and I'll take their soul instead. That makes sense, right? Oh, if you do hurt Asgore, I'll take the human souls, cross the barrier, and beat the hell out of you. That's what friends are for, right? Now, let's get the hell out of this flaming house. Well, that was fun, huh? We'll have to hang out again another time. But, somewhere else, I guess. In the meantime, I guess I'll go hang with Pyrus. So if you need me, drop by Snowden, okay? Oh, if you need help, just give Papyrus a ring. Since we're in the same spot, I'll be able to talk too. Well, see you later, punk. Oh, wait. This is sudden, but can you... Your inventory's full. I'll be at Papyrus's. Come see me when you have less stuff. Damn it, I forgot about my inventory. I have not done other routes. At this moment, I'm not interested in doing other routes, although maybe I'll do those some other time. So, put away some of these things, because I don't need them. We'll equip the locket. Oh, I have to go to the other side to access this. This must be a body of water in the middle. Yeah, I might come back and do the other routes some other time, but this is my first run, although I happen to know everything about the game, so... It's a different way to experience the game. I tend not to like RPGs. I tend not to like violent games. So it took more than a bit of coaxing to get me to play this, but I'm enjoying it. So, I have a favor to ask. I need you to deliver this letter to Alphys. Why don't I do it? Well, it's kind of personal, but we're friends, so I'll tell you. Hotland sucks. I don't want to have to go over there. So here you go. You got the Undyne's letter. Oh, and if you read it, I'll kill you. Thanks. You're the best.
The letter's not to Papyrus.
Yeah, Undyne's got a point. Why didn't she write a letter to me instead? Fine. You want a letter? I'll give you a letter. You get an F. Oh no. What's the F for? Friendship.
You tried to open it, but it's been shut so tightly you need a chainsaw to open it. Despite what seems like common sense, you threw away the letter. So, Undyne, how's it hanging?
What? You lost the letter? What the heck? How? Why? It's unbelievable. I should really be disappointed in you, but to tell you the truth, I'm kind of relieved. While you were gone, I actually wrote a way better letter. And this time, you won't lose it. I guarantee it.
Okay. That's the same dialogue. Let's go, go, go.
Oh my god, I'm gonna freaking kill you.
It's too powerful to throw away. Gets the better of you. Wait, can I give Papyrus the letter? I mean, I know I tried to put it in his mailbox, but can I try handing it to him?
Undyne writes a lot of letters, but she can never seem to find the right words. So when she goes to deliver them herself, she always quits, so she can come back and rewrite. That's why she asked you, because you have no standards.
Yeah. He's probably right. I mean, I'm just a human. Tra-la-la, care for a ride? I'm going to Hotland.
Fetch quest, here we go. Or come.
I'm having a little concert. Really, when would that concert be? Come again sometime. Tra-la-la. Ah, determination. It'd be cool if somebody made a mod of this game where they just replaced the word determination with the word beer. Just like, you're filled with beer.
Oh no, is that another letter? I don't want to open it. Can't I just slide it back out? No, I can't just keep doing this. I'll read this one. It's shut kind of strongly, isn't it? Wait a second. Hey, if this is a joke, it's... Oh my god, did you write this letter? Wasn't signed, so I had no idea who could have... Oh my god, oh no. That's adorable. And I had no idea you wrote that way. Surprising, too. After all the gross stuff I did, I didn't really deserve to be forgiven. Much less, this? And so passionately, too. You know what? Okay, I'll do it. It's the least I can do to make it up to you. Yeah, let's go on a date. Sorry. I'm still getting dressed. How do I look? My friend helped me pick this dress out. She's got a great sense of... anyway, let's do this thing. Hey, wait. Actually, we still can't start the date yet.
Dating stop.
Gotta give you items to raise your affection statistic first. That'll increase the chance of a successful outcome to the date, right? Anyway, don't worry. I'm prepared. I've been stockpiling gifts for anticipation for a date like this. First, I've got some metal armor polish. Maybe you can't use that, but I've also brought some waterproof cream for your scales. Well, how about this magical spear repair kit? Let's forget the items. Let's just start the date. Yeah, let's, date.
Can we start?
Do you, like, anime?
Yeah, I do.
Hey, me too! Hey, let's go somewhere. Where's a good place to go on a date? I got it. Let's go to the garbage dump.
Oh, well, that's beautiful, actually. I had no idea from the black and white, sprites just what a colorful, scenic place this would be. This really surprises me. Although I guess a dump could look like this if it's very well kept, or at least some parts of it might. Wow.
Here we are. This is where Undyne and I come all the time. We find all sorts of great stuff here. She's really, oh no, that's her over there. I can't let her see me on a date with you. Why? Because, well, oh no, here she comes.
Hey, there you are. I realized if you deliver that thing, it might be a bad idea. So I'm gonna do it. Give it to me.
You don't have it?
Ah, have you at least seen her?
I'm gonna lie to you just because I can.
No. But she wasn't at home. Where the heck could she be?
Oh my god. Well, I guess it's obvious, huh? I really like her. I mean, more than I like other people. I'm sorry, I just figured, you know, it'd be fun to go on a cute kind of pretend date with you to make you feel better. Well, it sounds even worse when I put it like that. I'm sorry. Undyne's the person I really want to go on a date with, but I mean, she's way out of my league. Not that you aren't, cool, but Undyne, she's so confident and strong and funny. And I'm just a nobody, a fraud. I'm the royal scientist, but all I've ever done is hurt people. Told her so many lies, she thinks I'm a lot cooler than I actually am. If she gets close to me, she'll find out the truth about me. What should I do? The truth? But if I tell her that, she'll hate me. Isn't it better this way? To live a lie where both people are happy, or a truth where neither of us are? They say be yourself, but I don't really like who myself is. I'd rather just be whatever people... whatever makes people like me. Heh. No, you're right. Every day I'm scared. Scared what will happen if people learn the truth on their own. They'll get all hurt because of me. But how can I tell Undyne the truth? I don't have the confidence. I'm gonna mess it up. How can I practice?
Obviously, let's roleplay it.
Roleplay? That actually sounds kind of fun. Okay, which one of us will be Undyne?
Here, you be Undyne.
Me? Undyne? Okay. I'll say what I think she'd say, and you show me what I'm supposed to do.
Nah, hey, Alphys, you look cute today. Which I say often, but platonically, because I would never like you. Yo, you're one hot baby.
What? Alphys?
what's gotten into you? Hot baby, how dare you call me that? First of all, I'm a baby knight, captain of the babies. Treat my position with respect, or I'll strike you down. Now, pretend I'm suplexing Boulder for no reason. Anyway, what would you like to say, Alphys? Alphys gives you a kiss. What? I would never. Alphys, what are you doing? I say, pushing yourself away from me. You shouldn't kiss me. But you're so good at it. Because of what you learned from those dating video games. I can't help but kiss you back. Ah, I'm on time and I'm piling on the smooches!
What did you just say?
I'm dying. I was just...
Hey, whoa, wait a sec.
Your outfit's really cute. What's the occasion?
Wait a sec. Are you two on a date?
Yes? Actually, we were only romantically roleplaying as you.
What?
Undyne, I've been lying to you.
What?
About what? About, well, everything. Told you that seaweed was, like, scientifically important, and really I just use it to make ice cream. And those human history books I keep reading, those are just dorky comic books. And history movies, those are just anime. They aren't real. And the time I told you I was busy with work on my phone, I was just eating frozen yogurt in my pajamas, and the time...
Alphys.
I just wanted to impress you. I just wanted you to think I was smart and cool. I wasn't some nerdy loser. Alphys. Undyne, I really think you're neat, okay?
Alphys. Shh.
Alphys. I think you're neat too, I guess. But you gotta realize, most of what you said doesn't really matter to me. I don't care if you're watching kid cartoons or reading history books. To me, all that stuff's just nerdy crap. What I like is that you're passionate and analytical. Doesn't matter what it is, you care about it. 100% in maximum power. So, you won't have to lie to me. I don't want you to lie to anyone anymore. Alphys, I want you to help you become happy with who you are. I know just the training you need to do that. Undying, you're gonna train me?
Me?
Nah, I'm gonna get Papyrus to do it. Get to those bones shaking. It's time to jog 100 laps, hooting about how great we are. Ready? I'm about to start the timer. Undying. I'll do my best.
Oh my god,
she was kidding, right? Those cartoons, comics, they're still real, right? Anime is real, right? No! I can feel my heart breaking into pieces. Oh, I can survive this. I have to be strong for Alphys. Thank you, human, for telling me the truth. I'll try my best to live in this world. See you later. My good friend who trusts me. This is Papyrus. You're also mutual friend. Alphys and I finished our training early. Very early. So I sent her home. Very home. Now I feel strongly, and for no apparent reason, you should also go there. To her lab, house, thing. I have only good feelings about this. Goodbye.
Oh,
Well, if there's one thing we've learned, it's that we can trust Papyrus with our life.
Right?
If he's got only good feelings about this, then only good things can happen. Let's go back to Hotland, and we're off. We're off to see the wizard, the wonderful Wizard of Oz. Tra-la-la. I should have worn a few million more pairs of pants today. Why would you wear that? We're going to Hotland. It's pretty warm here. Just saying. Come again sometime. Tra-la-la. Let's see. Defense of 11. Can I take some food? Apparently not. Let's see, I have to go visit a store somewhere. Actually, I think there's... I could get some food somewhere here too, I think. It's a note from Alphys. It's hard to read because of the handwriting, but you try your best.
Hey! Thanks for your help back there. You guys, your support really means a lot to me. But as difficult as it is to say this, you guys alone can't magically make my own problems go away. I want to be a better person. I don't want to be afraid anymore, but... And for that to happen, I have to be able to face my own mistakes. I'm gonna go start doing that now. I want to be clear, this isn't anyone else's problem but mine. But if you don't ever hear from me again, if you want to know the truth, enter the door to the north of this note. You all at least deserve to know what I did.
I have no choice but to exit this way. Now, tree number one. This is it. Time to do what the king asked me to do. I'll create the power to free us all. I'll unleash the power of the soul. The barrier is locked by soul power. Unfortunately, this power cannot be recreated artificially. Soul power can only be derived from what was once living. So, to create more, we'll have to use what we have now, the souls of monsters. But extracting a soul from a living monster would require incredible power. Besides being impractical, doing so would instantly destroy the soul's host. And unlike the persistent souls of humans, souls of most monsters disappear immediately upon death. If only I could make a monster's soul last. I've done it. Using the blueprints, I've extracted it from the human souls. I believe this is what gives their souls the strength to persist after death. The will to keep living, the resolve to change fate. Let's call this power determination. Elevator. Lost power. Enter the center door. We got some chisps. Can't go that way. Asgore asked everyone outside the city for monsters that had fallen down. Their bodies came in today. They're still comatose, and soon they'll all turn into dust. But what happens if I inject determination into them? If their souls persist after they perish, then freedom might be closer than we all thought. Things aren't going well. None of the bodies have turned into dust, so I can't get the souls. I've told the families I'd give them the dust back for the funerals. People are starting to ask me what's happening. What do I do? Ouch. That hurts. Drain. Dropped it.
Nothing's happening. I don't know what to do. I'll just keep injecting everything with determination. I want this to work. One of the bodies opened its eyes. Everyone that had fallen down has woken up. They're all walking around and talking like nothing is wrong. I thought they were goners. Seems like this research was a dead end. But at least we got a happy ending out of it. I sent the souls back to Asgore, returned the vessel to his garden. And I called all the families and told them everyone's alive. I'll send everyone back tomorrow.
No, 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 no!
Under sheets. We're researching humans to see if I can find any info about their souls. I ended up snooping around the castle. I found these weird tapes. I don't feel like Asgore's watched them. I don't think he should. Corey, wake up.
What is it, dear? Why do you have that video camera?
I want to get your reaction. Corey, dearest, what is my favorite vegetable?
Carrots, right?
Oh, my favorite vegetable is
edamame.
Get it?
Go back to bed, dear.
Not yet. Now, if I were a dog, what kind of dog would I be?
I don't know, honey. What kind of dog would you be?
I would be
a Pomeranian. You sure are excited to have this child. You know, if you keep making jokes like that, one day you could be a famous Pomeranian. Well,
I'm going to bed.
Hey, come on, Tori. That wasn't as funny.
I know, I'm just teasing you. Good night, dear.
Good night.
Oh dear, perhaps it is too dark in here for the video to come out. Okay, Escher. You ready? Do your creepy face. Ah! Hee hee hee. Oh wait! I had the lens cap on. You're not gonna do it again. Come on, quit tricking me. Howdy, Usher. Smile for the camera. This time I got you. I left the lens cap on purpose. Now you're smiling for no reason. What? Oh, yeah, I remember. When we tried to make butterscotch pie for Dad, right? That recipe asked for cups of butter, but we accidentally put in buttercups.
Yeah, those flowers got him really sick. I felt so bad. We made Mom really upset. I should have laughed it off like you did. Anyway, where were we going with this? Turn off the camera. Okay. I don't like this idea, Escher. No, I'm not. Big kids don't cry. Yeah, you're right. No, I never doubt you, Escher. Never. We'll be strong. We'll free everyone. I'll go get the flowers. Escher, can you hear me? We want you to wake up.
Escher, you still have to stay determined. You can't give up. You're the future of humans and monsters.
Escher, please, wake up. I don't like this plan anymore. No, I said I'd never doubt you. Six, right? We just have to get six, and we'll do it together, right? Curtain.
Be honest, I'm a bit lost here. I'll do the one other thing I know about. I'm missing a key. And as far as I can tell, it's not this way. Because this is the initial passageway we entered. There's nothing special hidden over here. And that's the extent of that. So where else could it be? This is the entranceway. I'm just trying to use process of elimination to say where I can continue searching before I commit all my time to searching in the back room. Yeah. So, I have no choice but to search in that cloudy room. Because I've looked at everything else in the lab. It's gotta be this way. I didn't try this way before. We'll need a vessel to wield the monster souls when the time comes. After all, a monster cannot absorb the souls of other monsters. Just as a human cannot absorb a human soul. So, what about something that's neither human nor monster? Golden flowers. Experiments on the vessel are a failure. Doesn't seem to be any different from the control cases. They're a hassle to work with anyway. The seeds just stick to you and won't let go. Hold. Now that Meditan's made it big, he never talks to me anymore, except to ask when I'm going to finish his body. But I'm afraid if I finish his body, he won't need me anymore. We'll never be friends again. Not to mention, every time I try to work on it, it just gets really sweaty. Endogeny, or as you pronounce it properly, endogeny, is contented. But I tend to think that it's endogeny or endogeny that they were going for. Oh. Just for curiosity's sake, what's in here? Nothing, it's just empty. Families keep calling me to ask when everyone's coming home. What am I supposed to say? I don't even answer the phone anymore. Asgore left me 5 messages today. 4 about everyone being angry. One about this cute teacup you found that looks like me. Thanks, Asgore. I spend all my time at the garbage dump now. It's my element. We already explored that. Oops, wrong way. Was there a room up this way? Or was that just the room with the curtain? This is the curtain room. So the room I'm looking for is down and to the right. I guess the clue was cold, which makes sense that I would look in the refrigerator for it. Unless it's like one of Undyne's refrigerators.
stop. I got you guys some food, okay? Sorry about that. They get kind of sassy when they don't get fed on time. Anyway, power went out, and I've been trying to turn it back on. But it seems you were one step ahead of me. This is probably just a big inconvenience for you, but I appreciate that you came down here to back me up. As I said, I was afraid I might not come back, but that's not because of these guys or anything. I was just worried I'd be too afraid to tell the truth that I might run away or do something cowardly. I suppose I owe you an explanation. As you already know, or probably know, Asgore asked me to study the nature of souls. During my research, I isolated a power I called determination. I injected it into dying monsters so their souls would last after death. But the experiment failed. You see, unlike humans, monsters' bodies don't have enough physical matter to take these concentrations of determination. Their bodies started to melt and lost what physicality they had. Pretty soon, all the test subjects had melted together into those. Seeing them like this, I knew I couldn't tell their families about it. I couldn't tell anyone. No matter how much everyone was asking me, and I was too afraid to do any more work, knowing everything I'd done so far being such a horrific failure. But now, I've changed my mind about all this. I'm gonna tell everyone what I've done. It's gonna be hard. Being honest, believing in myself. I'm sure there will be times where I'll struggle. I'm sure there will be times where I screw up again, but knowing deep down that I have friends to fall back on, I know it'll be a lot easier to stand on my own. Thank you. Come on, guys. It's time for everyone to go home.
I've chosen a candidate. I haven't told Asgore yet, because I want to surprise him with it. In the center of his garden, there's something special. The first golden flower that grew before all the others. A flower from the outside world. It appeared just before the queen left. I wonder, what happens when something without a soul gains the will to live? The flower's gone.
Asher, are you there? It's been a long time, hasn't it? But you've done well. Thanks to you, everything has fallen into place. Asher, see you soon. This is the barrier. This is what keeps us all trapped underground. If by chance you have any unfinished business, please do what you must. I see. This is it then. Ready. Human, it was nice to meet you. Goodbye.
What a miserable creature, torturing such a poor, innocent youth. Do not be afraid, my child. It is I, Toriel, your friend and guardian. At first, I thought I would let you make your journey alone, but I could not stop worrying about you. Your adventure must have been so treacherous, and ultimately, it would burden you with a horrible choice. To leave this place, you'd have to take the life of another person. You'd have to defeat Asgore. However, I realized I cannot allow that. It is not right to sacrifice someone simply to let someone leave here. Is that not what I've been trying to prevent this whole time? So, for now, let us suspend this battle. As terrible as Asgore is, he deserves mercy too.
Tori, you came back.
Do not Tori me, dreamer. You pathetic whelp. If you really wanted to free our kind, you could have gone through the barrier after you got one soul, taken 6 souls from the humans and come back, and freed everyone peacefully. But instead, you made everyone live in despair, because you would rather wait here, meekly hoping that never another human soul comes.
Tori, you're right. I'm a miserable creature. But do you think we can at least be friends again?
No, Asgore.
Yeah, Asgore, human. No one fight each other. Everyone's gonna make friends or else I'll...
Hello, I am Toriel. Are you the human's friend? It's nice to meet you.
Yeah. Nice to meet you. Hey, Asgore, is that your ex? Jeez, that's rough, buddy. Hey, no one hurt each other.
Oh, are you another friend? I'm Toriel. Hello.
Hi. There's 2 of them?
Hey,
nobody... oh, shoot, I forget. Hey, nobody fight anyone. If anyone fights anyone, then I'll be forced to ask Undyne for help. Hello. Oh, hello, Your Majesty. Hey, human. Did Asgore shave? And clone himself?
Hey, guys. What's up?
A voice. Hello. I think we may know each other.
Oh, hey. Recognize your voice, too.
I'm Toriel. So nice to meet you.
Name's Sans. And, some...
Oh, wait, then. This must be your brother, Papyrus. Greetings, Papyrus. It's nice to finally meet you. Your brother has told me so much about you.
Wowee! I can't believe Asgore's clone knows who I am. It's the best day of my life.
Hey, Papyrus. What does a skeleton tile his room with?
Snowproof roof tiles?
No, silly. A skeleton tiles his roof with shingles.
I changed my mind. This is the worst day of my life.
Come on, Asgore. It's gonna be okay. There's plenty of fish in the sea.
Yeah, Asgore. Undyne's totally right about that fish thing. Sometimes you just gotta stop going after furry boss monsters and just get to know a really cute fish. It's a metaphor.
Well,
I think it's a pretty good analogy. Oh my god. Will you two just smooch already? The audience is dying for some romantic action.
Hey, shut up.
Man, the nerve of that guy. Right? Elvis? No, he's right. Let's do it.
Well, I guess.
If you want to. Don't hold anything back. Wait! Not in front of the human. Oh. Right, sorry. Got carried a little away there. Hee-hee-hee. My child, it seems as if you must stay here for a while. But looking at all the great friends you have made and put in a straight line with each other for some reason, as if we're doing a photo op or something else, I think you'll be happy here. Hey, that reminds me. Pyrus, you called everyone here, right? Well, besides, her. Anyway, if I got here before you, how'd you know to call everybody? Let's just say, a tiny flower helped me. A tiny flower? Ah, yes. You idiots. While you were having your little powwow, I took the human souls. And now, not only those under my power, but all your friends' souls are going to be mine. Too. Hee hee. And you know what the best part is? It's all your fault. It's all because you made them love you. All the time you spent listening to them, encouraging them, caring about them, without that, you wouldn't have come here. And now, with their souls and the humans together, I will achieve my real form. Why am I still doing this? Don't you get it? It's all just a game. If you leave the underground satisfied, you'll win the game. If you win, you won't want to play with me anymore. What would I do then? This game between us will never end. I'll hold victory in front of you just within your reach, and then tear it away before you grasp it. Over and over. Listen, if you do defeat me, I'll give you your happy ending. I'll bring your friends back and destroy the barrier. Everyone will finally be satisfied, but that won't happen. You, I'll keep you here no matter what. Even if it means killing you a million times.
Oh, sorry, didn't mean to make the music and everything imbalanced. We'll change the balance right now, or at least make an attempt to. One second. Okay, back to the game. You're still good. What?
Do not be afraid, my child. No matter what happens, we will always be there to protect you. That's right, human. You can win. Just do what I would do. Believe in you.
Hey, human. If you got past me, you can do anything. It's no worry. We're with you all the way.
Yeah, you haven't beaten this guy yet? Come on. He's got nothing on you.
Technically, it's impossible for you to beat him, but somehow I know you can do it.
Human, the future of humans and monsters. You have to stay determined.
La la la, all the other voices. I'm not gonna do it. Sorry.
Unbelievable. This can't be happening. You...
I can't believe you're all so stupid. All of your souls are mine. Finally, I was so tired of being a flower. Howdy. Escher, are you there? It's me, your best friend. You know, I don't care about destroying this world anymore. After I defeat you and gain total control over the timeline, I just want to reset everything. All your progress, everyone's memories, I'll bring them all back to zero. Then we could do everything all over again. You know what the best part of all this is? You'll do it. And then you'll lose to me again. Again. And again. Because you want a happy ending. because you love your friends. Because you never give up. Oh, you got me. That was good. Sorry, that's really challenging for me. So bear with me. Yeah, no, I get the concept. It's just being able to count is challenging for me. So, this might take a little while. Seeing as I'm just a bit challenged with both timing and counting, that thing's a little tricky. Isn't that delicious? Your determination, that power that can get you this, that let you get this far, it's gonna be your downfall. Now, enough messing around. It's time to purge this timeline once and for all. After that attack, you're still standing in my way. Wow, you really are something special. Don't get cocky. Up until now, I've only been using a fraction of my real power. Let's see what good your determination is against this. Oh, yeah, Temi armor would be a good thing at around now. Oh, I can't hit left or right. Interesting. hold my true power. Well, that didn't last long. Every time you die, your grip on this world slips away. Every time you die, your friends forget you a little more. Your life will end here in a world where no one remembers you. Still, you're hanging on. That's fine. In a few moments, you'll forget everything, too. That attitude will serve you well in your next life. Still? Come on, show me what good your determination is now. did you do? What's this feeling? What's happening to me? No, I don't need anyone. Stop it! Get away from me! Do you hear me? I'll tear you apart! Escher, do you know why I'm doing this? Why I keep fighting to keep you around? I'm doing this because you're special, Escher. You're the only one that understands me. You're the only one who's any fun to play with anymore. No, that's not just it. I'm doing this because I care about you, Escher. I care about you more than anybody else. I'm not ready for this to end. I'm not ready for you to leave. I'm not ready to say goodbye to someone like you again. So please stop doing this and just let me win. Stop it! Stop it now! Escher. I'm so alone, Escher. I'm so afraid, Escher. Escher, I I'm so sorry. I always was a crybaby, wasn't I, Escher? I know. You're not actually Escher, are you? Escher's been gone for a long time. What is your name? Frisk? That's a nice name. Frisk, I haven't felt like this for a long time. As a flower, I was soulless. I lacked the power to love other people. However, with everyone's souls inside me, I not only have my own compassion back, but I can feel every other monster's as well. They all care about each other so much, and they care about you too, Frisk. I wish I could tell you how everyone feels about you. Virus, Sans, Undyne, Alpheus, Toriel. Monsters are weird. Even though they barely know you, it feels like they all really love you. Huh. Frisk, I understand if you can't forgive me. I understand if you hate me. I acted so strange and horrible. I hurt you. I hurt so many people, friends, family, bystanders. There's no excuse for what I've done.
What? Frisk, come on. You're gonna make me cry again. Besides, even if you do forgive me, I can't keep these souls inside of me. The least I can do is return them. But first, there's something I have to do. Right now, I can feel everyone's hearts beating as one. They're all burning with the same desire, with everyone's power, with everyone's determination. It's time for monsters to finally go free.
Barrier was destroyed.
Frisk, I have to go now. Without the power of everyone's souls, I can't keep maintaining this form. In a little while, I'll turn back into a flower. I'll stop being myself. I'll stop being able to feel love again. So, Frisk, it's best if you just forget about me. Okay? Just go be with the people who love you. I don't want to let go. Frisk, you're gonna do a great job, okay? No matter what you do, everyone will be there for you, okay? Well, my time's running out. Goodbye. By the way, Frisk, take care of Mom and Dad for me, okay? Just a bad dream. Please, wake up. Oh, you are awake. Thank goodness. You're so worried. Felt like you were out forever.
Yeah. Any longer, I would have freaked out. Tell us next time you decide to take a nap, okay?
Yeah, you made Papyrus cry like a baby.
What? I didn't cry. I don't cry. I just caught something in my eye.
What did you catch?
Tears!
No, now. The important part is that Frisk is all right. Here, Frisk. Why not drink some tea? It'll make you feel better.
Or how about we give them space first? They must be very exhausted. Though, from what, I'm not certain. Frisk, we do not remember exactly what happened. there was a flower, and then everything went white. But now the barrier is gone. When you are ready, we will all return to the surface. It seems the door to the east will lead us there now. But before then, perhaps you might want to take a walk. You can say goodbye to all of your wonderful friends. Do as you wish. We will all wait for you here. Alright, do enjoy. I'm going to take a brief intermission here. Be back in a couple minutes. Oh dear. Hello, Frisk. Alfie's upgraded my phone. I'm having a lot of fun with the texting feature. Sans, check out this one.
Oh man, Tori. That's brutal.
I can't believe the Queen has returned, and that also she's huge dork. You two are 2 feet away from each other. Why are you texting?
Worry not, Papyrus. We are texting for a good reason.
Why is that?
Well, because we're huge dorks.
Sans, please do not say that. You are not a dork. You are more of a bonehead.
Ha ha! Wow, those puns are even less funny coming from her.
Then why are you smiling?
It's a pity smile.
Frisk, do not feel left out. I have been writing messages to you as well. You still have my phone number after all this time, do you not? Dear Frisk, Sans and Alfie's are teaching me how to text. I am learning so much. For example, do you know what a smiley is? Now turn your head to the left. It's a picture of me smiling at you. Can you see it? LOL. Sincerely, Toriel.
Hey, Frisk. What's with that weird expression?
Sans, did I tell you about the time Frisk flirted with me? And then asked to call me mother?
Oh boy.
Wow, Frisk. This really puts our relationship in a new light.
Hey, Tori. Do you have any other embarrassing stories?
Oh, do I ever. But I think that story is one of the most unbelievable. It's hard to think anyone would want to flirt with me. Oh, Toriel, you have no idea.
Sorry, I don't have time to talk, Frisk. I'm supposed to be working right now.
But you aren't working.
I know. It's taking all my concentration.
So, Asgore, how about making me a member of the Royal Guard?
Well, Papyrus, now the war's over, we might not need the Royal Guard anymore.
What? Then what was the point of the human's quest? They journeyed all that way, and I'm still not a member of the Royal Guard. Truly, this is the worst possible ending. It seems like you really botched your quest, Frisk. But I, the great Papyrus, will always be a friend.
No matter how hard you try to get rid of him.
Hey, that's true.
So, Alfies, what do you want to do now that we're all free? We have the whole world to explore.
Well, of course, I'm going to go out and... No, I should be honest. I'm going to stay inside and watch anime like a total loser.
That's the spirit. Everyone, a celebration to being losers.
Heh, Papyrus is the right idea. Losing to Frisk is the best thing to ever happen to me. So I'm glad that we... When is it, Asgore?
What's an anime?
Oh my god. Frisk, please. Help me explain what anime is to Asgore. You see, it's like a cartoon. But... with swords.
So it's like a cartoon, but with swords? Golly, that sounds neato. Where is this? Where can I see the anime?
Hold on, I think I have some on my phone. Here, look at this. Never mind.
Golly,
are those two robots?
What was his voice again?
Guessing.
Boy, technology sure is something, isn't it?
Sure is.
Hey, Alfies. You think we could watch something with fighting next? Oh, and then something with princesses? Or fighting princesses?
I'll see if I can manage to find anything like that, Undyne.
Yeah.
Frisk, you gotta tell me. Do you think Asgore and Toriel are ever gonna get back together? Yeah, that's what I thought. Women can dream though, right? And write fan fiction. A lot of fan fiction. On second thought, maybe I won't write fanfic of real people. I mean, isn't real life already the greatest fan fiction of all? Don't tell anyone I said that, because I'm going to post it online. I'm sure excited to use the human internet. I'm sure they got all sorts of things Undyne that I can watch.
Oh man, we're going to be able to watch anime online.
Of course, Undyne. What do you think we've been fighting for all along?
Yeah, What do you think? Whoops.
Jinx, I knew you were gonna make that joke. Wait, Delphys, I didn't know you knew Sans. Well, I...
Doesn't everybody?
Who the hell is Sans? Who the heck is Sans? Tauriel! Risk, why don't you go look for Bedtime? He was here for a while, too. But he said he had to go somewhere.
Well, I'm gonna wrap it up.
Bye, Asgore.
Hi.
Isn't it beautiful, everyone?
Wow. It's even better than on TV. Way better. Better than I ever imagined.
Frisk, you live with us? The sunlight's so nice. The air is so fresh. I finally feel alive.
Hey, Sans. What's that giant ball?
I'm called up the sun, my friend.
That's the sun? Wowie! I can't believe I'm finally meeting the sun.
I could stand here and watch this for hours.
Yes, it is beautiful, is it not? But we should really think about what comes next.
Oh, right. Everyone, this is the beginning of a bright new future. An era of peace between humans and monsters.
Risk. I have something to ask of you. Will you act as our ambassador to the humans? Yeah, Frisk will be the best ambassador, and I, the Great Papyrus, will be the best mascot. I'll go make a good first impression.
Well, someone's gotta keep him from getting into trouble. See ya.
Man, do I have to do everything? Papyrus, wait!
Hey, Undyne, wait up!
Oops. Should I do something? Well, gotta go.
Seems that everyone is quite eager to set off. Frisk, you came from this world, right? So you must have a place to return to, do you not? What will you do now? What? Frisk, you really are a funny child. If you had said that earlier, none of this would have happened. It's a good thing you took so long to change your mind. Well, I suppose, if you really do not have any other place to go, I will do my best to take care of you for as long as you need. All right? Now, come along. Everyone's waiting for us.
it was over.
I mean, we haven't even done the special thanks yet. Ready? Let's end all of this for good.